Coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the Minnesota Twins and the Atlanta Braves. Two great hitters lead their teams to battle next on MLB Network. Bartolo Colon is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Braves. What do you have for us on him, H?
Well, Matt, how I'd categorize this guy, I'd say he's a very reliable major league pitcher. Last year, ERA under 3.5, but he's consistent. What you see is what you get. He gives you innings, and he takes the ball for you.
Here's Brian Dozier now. He will lead this one off today.
Second baseman, number two.
Left. Side of the infield into the shift. Garcia over to his left, and he's retired one away. And now here's a look at the Minnesota Twins starting lineup. Harold, what's the key for them today?
Tell you what, Matt, they got a great pitcher going, so it takes the pressure off the offense. You know, you don't need 5 or 6 runs to win a game. You just scrape out a couple, and he's going to make it stand up.
Jorge Polanco is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one. And he gets him to lift one high in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Swanson ranges back, and he has it for out number two.
Batting third, first baseman number 7, Joe Mauer.
So here's Joe Mauer. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. In there for strike one, 0-1.
Hey, not a bad take there on that first pitch. Not a real good idea to go up there looking for a changeup to hit. Sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Chopped weakly to the left. Throw won't be in time as he reaches it first.
Well, there's an infield single with two outs. You know, never too late to get a rally started. I love the hustle right there to get things going.
Here's Miguel Sano. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner.
He certainly hasn't been the aggressor in this at bat. Two straight takes, so now we'll see if he can change his approach and battle up.
Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. One left for Minnesota, and now the Braves will get their initial shot here. No score. Phil Hughes, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Well, as you can see, he's a tall drink of water out there, especially on the mound. That can really work to your advantage because you work on more of a downhill plane and you typically get more extension to the plate on your release. The key, though, is that he has to be out front with his release point or he'll be more likely to miss up in the zone.
Ender Inciarte.
This is flared out towards second. One away.
Out. Batting second, the shortstop.
And next will be Dansby Swanson digging in. First pitch on its way. Good swing. Just got to try and straighten that one out.
Well, he got what he's looking for. He just got out in front of it right there.
And before the pitch here, time is asked for and granted by Woody Keller, the home plate umpire. Bases are empty. One man out. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. This is lined to left, but pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made all the difference.
Striding into the box, Freddie Freeman. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. First pitch coming now from Hughes. Well hit by Freeman as this one's in the air to deep right field. And gone. An absolute bomb. A solo home run. A solo home run off the bat of Freddie Freeman. As the Braves get on the board first, it's 1-0. Sure that ball's ever going to be found. It went so far. One of the most impressive home runs we've ever seen, and the show track numbers are just ridiculous. Get this, the projected distance registered at over 500 feet. Very few balls in history have reached that territory, so expect to see that one on highlight reels for a long time to come.
Batting fourth, left fielder.
So here's Matt Kemp now. The swing and lift the ball fouled off to the left and out of play.
Man, he's flirting with danger. He gave up a home run on that very same pitch, and this time he comes right back with it in another dangerous location. He better be careful.
Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Hughes steps into the windup, looking for the strikeout here on 0-2. Now this one is blasted to left field, and there's no doubt about it. Back-to-back jacks. It's a solo shot here for Matt Kemp, and it's given Atlanta a 2-0 lead. Sure, you know it's coming after that bomb. That's right. Let's check it out on Show Track. And as the numbers come in, we see it was projected at over 450 feet. An incredible home run to watch. Here's Nick Markakis now, the right fielder. He'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Here's Hughes now on 0-1. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And that'll get down for a base hit. So Brandon Phillips will bat next with two away.
That ball's right in his wheelhouse. You may as well take out a tee, set the ball right there, and say hit it as hard as you can. Because that's what he did.
Brandon Keller.
Here's Brandon Phillips as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. A runner on first with two away. Out in front here is Phillips as he lifts a high drive out to deep left field. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. A two-run home run for Brandon Phillips, and the Braves add on. It's 4-0.
The manager talks about hitting being contagious. That is exactly what we're talking about. One guy tees off, and the guy behind him starts to feel a little bit more confident, a little bit more focused. The next thing you know, you've got three home runs in an inning, and your entire offense is off and running.
Looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Way out in front as this is yanked foul into the seats in left.
Well, that was an impressive swing. A fastball, he'll hit a foul ball home run with it, but he got out in front of it a little bit too much. Timing just a tad off.
Again, he sends it out of play. The next 0-2. Line drive to left. That gets down, and the inning continues. So the bottom of the inning is still alive after the two-out base hit.
Oh, they're making a statement already here in the first inning. We got the two-run home run, and now he gets a base hit following the home run. They came out today swinging.
Here now is the catcher, Tyler Flowers. And he's first pitch swinging here as he lines this one into left field for a base hit.
Another first pitch hit. Man, they're going up there aggressive, looking for that first pitch fastball. He's struggling right now, and they are feasting.
Into the box now, Bartolo Colon, swing and a line drive. That's in there, base hit. And they'll put the brakes on that runner at third, and that means the bases are loaded now with two away.
This is the one advantage the National League has, I believe, in an interleague game. Here's a pitcher, gets a base hit, he's used to hitting. The American League is kind of sitting there going, this is how you do it, guys.
Here's Ender Inciarte. She'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Four runs here in this half inning. Out in front as this is pulled foul into the seats. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Kepler ranging back to the track. And this deflects right off him. And a second run is across. Colon rounds third and is digging for the plate. And he is in there.
Yeah, and I'm sure the pitcher is talking to himself on the mound, too. And I can't blame him. He's responsible for loading the bases. And he just served up a pitch that absolutely got roped for a bases clearing triple. One swing, three runs.
Into the box, Dansby Swanson. And a first pitch swing. He hits a fly ball to left center. Rosario is there to make the catch. And mercifully, the side. Not only do they take the lead, they also open it up a bit as seven men come across to score. Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. He leads off this half inning in what they hope will be a rebuttal to all those runs they just gave up.
Well, Matt, I think mentally they need to get one or two of these runs back right here. Just getting on the board after getting socked in the mouth by the opposing team can lift the team up a bit. We'll see if they can string something together.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's such an effective pitch if you can hit the corner with it, but no dice this time.
And the pitch on 2-1. Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat, 3-1. So let's take a peek at our umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Woody Keller.
Matt, I've got to be totally honest here. With Woody Keller behind the dish, don't be too surprised if you have a few questionable calls. It's not that he's consistently off, but I've been told it seems like he has a fairly tall strike zone. We'll keep an eye out for that.
And another foul ball. Payoff pitch one more time. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat.
All right, here's how the Braves line up defensively, brought to you by Majestic. And at first base, Freddie Freeman. Freddie can pick it, man. Throw the ball in the dirt. Freddie's coming up with it. And don't be surprised he does the splits on you every now and then.
So striding forward now, Eddie Rosario. He'll get to take his first cuts here. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one.
Pretty good pitch and a great take there. There's not a lot you could do with that slider breaking down and unless you can catch it way out front and hook it down the line. You see a lot of swinging misses on those.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A late swing at a slider for a strike. One out, nobody on. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
I like that they went away with that pitch right there. They really tried to tie him up on that previous pitch, so he was probably what we call inside conscious. He didn't get a strike there, but I'm guessing he was looking for another ball in.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
25, Byron Buxton.
Stepping in, Byron Buxton. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. Into the windup and the pitch. On the ground up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field. Didn't waste any time, like the first pitch he saw, to keep the inning going. And he's in there easily. It's a stand-up triple. The speed they always talk about with this guy was on full display there.
Yeah, when you've got elite speed like this guy does, Matt, you don't need any help from the fielders to give you more time. He's thinking extra bases as soon as the ball gets to the outfield, and that time he wanted three.
And he misses again, 2-0.
Well, this is where mental toughness has got to come in for the pitcher. He's got to focus on the hitter. Look, I know you gave up the triple, but it doesn't matter. Focus on the hitter with two outs, you get out of the inning.
And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike. Two outs here with a runner at third. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. No damage done after the two-out triple. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. He'll lead things off as they look to perhaps build on an already sizable lead. Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. And he takes a good swing at that one as this is sent down the line in right, but ultimately into the crowd at foul ball. 0-1 count and the pitch. Hit hard on the ground to first. And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted.
Now batting, left fielder.
Digging in for his second at bat, Matt Kemp. He went deep in his first at bat. We'll see what he's got in store for us here. Hot shot on the ground is short. And this is going to find its way into left for a one out knock.
So much for that taking the first pitch. Man, they are aggressive. You see them score several runs early in the game. I attribute that to the aggressive hitting.
Stepping in now, Nick Markakis. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. One for one after a single his first time up. Here's the 0-1. Pretty well hit. Deep down the line in right, but that's back into the seats. Foul. The 0-2 on its way from Hughes. Leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
Super play right there from the shortstop. Talk about showing off those hops. This was destined to be a base hit into the outfield.
In now, Brandon Phillips, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Oh, one count. Here's the pitch. Started that swing a bit too early.
Wow, that was a big swing. He's trying to hit another two-run homer. He's got a man on. He took the big hat. May as well start off the game with a two-run homer earlier.
A pause and the 0-2. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And this will wind up being nothing more than a long foul ball, and it'll hold the count at 0-2. Another 0-2 home. Line hard to the left side, but foul. The 0-2 once more. Line to the right side. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Braves. And welcome back to Cobb County, Georgia, for baseball on MLB Network. Third inning set to get underway. Danny Santana
for the pitcher Hughes
has moved into the on-deck circle now as he'll hit for the pitcher Hughes.
Santana.
Grounded to third. Garcia gloves it. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
The batter, number two, second baseman, Brian Dozier.
Ready for another chance? Brian Dozier, 0 for 1 here in the early going. Ball one. Colon ready with the 1-0. Hit down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
That pitch right there, he's trying to keep him from getting his arms extended. If it's out over the plate more, he can obviously do a lot of damage with it.
And he comes back with a gorgeous slider there for strike two. Bases are empty, one man out. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Back goes Kemp to the track, to the wall. Gone! It's a solo shot here from Brian Dozier, and they're now on the board, though still well behind.
That one definitely seems worth taking a look at with show track. It wasn't a particularly deep home run, but as you can see, he connected pretty well. 110 miles an hour off the bat, and it got out of here in a hurry.
And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Fastball, and he swings through it to fall behind. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Slider, and that's hit on the ground towards second. Phillips is up with it. Throw gets him. Two down.
Up next for the Twins, first baseman, Joe Mauer.
So here's Joe Mauer. Into the windup and the pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's a swing and a ground ball, but this will get foul for strike two. And a changeup that just about got away from him there as that ran in a bit too far. The 1-2 pitch. Look out, that one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Two out, nobody on. And this is in the air down the left field line and into foul territory. We'll reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. One for the Twins on this swing by Brian Dozier. Bottom of the third coming up. It's the Braves 7 and the Twins 1. Tyler Duffy is going to come on to pitch here, and in just the third inning, you have to think he'll be asked to eat some innings. Striding in once again, Adonis Garcia. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number three. Hit on the ground to third. Sano moving to his right. Throw on to first, and one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away.
Now batting.
Here now is the catcher, Tyler Flowers. The numbers against Tyler Duffy, not a big sample size, 0 for 1. A swing and a miss at the big curveball. Now the 0-1. This one's down to third. Sano fields it cleanly. On to first, and very quickly, two are gone here in the home third.
Now batting.
So stepping in, Bartolo Colon. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. The windup and the 0-1. This is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Buxton on the move, and that retires the side. Down in order go the Braves. They're on top 7-1. Here's Miguel Sano. He starts the inning, and Dan, they're down six in the early going. So what do they need to do to claw back into this thing?
Well, first of all, man, I think they need to start to get some base runners. It's hard to be patient when you're down by six, but base runners are the key to getting back into this one.
And boy, they're really giving him fits inside now as he can't get extended there, and it's 0-2 now. Trying to send him packing for the second time. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one. Comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ball game. The windup and the 0-1. A wave and a miss, a tick behind a good fastball. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And that one stayed too low, apparently. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Never fun to see a pitch come up and in, but obviously not being a fastball, he didn't mean anything by it.
2-2 count. Here it comes. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box now, Eddie Rosario. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
Now, when you've got a six-run lead out there, there's no reason not to go right at guys. You have to keep attacking the zone.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Sent foul again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. 2-2 is a changeup that misses. 3-2. And he struck him out. His seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Here's Ender Inciarte, 1-for-2 with a triple so far in this one.
Center fielder, number 11.
To first, Mauer is there, and he'll step on first himself for the out.
The batter number
and next
seven,
will be Dansby Swanson digging Dansby. In. 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. A fastball right down the middle for a strike. Seven runs, nine hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Buxton racing back. Out of here! A solo shot, and they add another. So a solo shot here to left center field, and this is now a 7-run ball game.
That's why you hear people say work down in the zone. This is such a difficult pitch to hit. The ball's up.
First baseman number 5, Freddie Freeman.
Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. One out, nobody on. Pulled toward right center field. Calling for it, Buxton. And he makes the catch for the second out. So here's Matt Kemp now. He's off to a fast start in this one. 2 for 2, including a home run. Into the windup and the pitch. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And this had home run distance, but it just does hook foul. And that's cut on and missed by Kemp as they move ahead of him now, 0-2.
I really like how the catcher and the pitcher are reading swings. The pitch before, big power swing. Then they pull the string on him and get him out in front early. He has no idea what's coming now.
And a sliding effort there at short, but this ball finds its way through for a base hit. He's around first, heading for two. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
The right fielder, number 22.
Here's Nick Markakis now, the right fielder. The numbers against Tyler Duffy, not a big sample size, 0 for 1. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And they're going to hold that runner at third base, as even with two away, they didn't like their chances there.
Second baseman, number 4, Brandon Keller.
Here's Brandon Phillips. A little bouncer. That winds up foul. 8 runs on 12 hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. Ripped down the line. A dive, but he can't make the play, and it's down the left field line. And the runner scores from third as they extend their lead. It's a 9-1 ball game.
Well, Matt, he's homered in this game. Drives in a run right there. This is third RBI of the ball game. He's doing his part.
Adonis Garcia digs in now. He swings and grounds it to short. And that'll get through into center field for a base hit. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
Well, nothing flashy about this base hit. Just a simple ground ball up the middle. But the one thing I do like is the approach to go up the middle. There's a lot of hits in the middle of the diamond.
Standing in now, Tyler Flowers. Looped out towards short. On to first, but it's too late as the first base umpire says they just missed getting him at the bag. And the hits just keep on a-coming against this arm.
Yeah, Matt, and I'm not sure how much longer they can leave him out there. Not only is he hurting the team, it's probably doing some damage to his psyche as well.
Digging in to try it again.
Bartolo Colon. And a chance now to increase his lead if he can deliver something here with two gone.
Suzuki.
First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one.
Matt, I just think he's pitching scared. Look, he's getting hit a little bit, and now he's falling behind another hitter. Challenge somebody.
1-0 pitch. And from deep in the hole, a jump throw to second. And he'll go the short way to retire the side. So all in all, they're fortunate to give up just three in the inning as they wind up escaping the bases loaded jam. Matt Vasgersian, Harold Reynolds, and Dan Plesac back with you as Byron Buxton readies to lead off the inning.
Buxton.
And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. Here it comes. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And the changeup is way low that time. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. And now time is called, and the reliever is warm out there. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. Now it looks like the Braves are going to get a lefty up and throwing in their bullpen. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
He's really struggled with his command in this game, no doubt about it. But to make things worse, he just lost one of the fastest guys in the
– Ian Kroll takes the ball here as he'll enter with a runner at first and nobody out.
Ian
Kroll. First pitch coming. Here it is. Jason Castro stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1.
I like that he used the curveball to get ahead there. That's a tough pitch to hit in this lefty-lefty matchup. So if you can get it over the plate on the first pitch, it can be pretty effective.
Here's the 0-1. Off-speed pitch, and this one runs in and nearly gets him here.
That was a changeup, so there really wasn't any intent behind it. Looked to me like it just slipped out of his hand a little bit. That'll happen sometimes because of the grip of that straight changeup.
This one's chopped foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. Started to chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball two. And he struck him out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Stepping in now, Tyler Duffy. And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection.
The batter, number two, second baseman.
Digging in and looking for more, Brian Dozier. Comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Now Dozier with a drive out to left field. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. His second home run of the game. But they still face a 7-run deficit. Sure, you know it's coming after that bomb. That's right. Let's check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, we see it was projected at over 450 feet. An incredible home run to watch.
Now back.
Into the box, Jorge Polanco. As he'll come up empty there as he misses the off-speed pitch for strike one. No hits to this point. And this is high, a ball and a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. A ball and two strikes to count now with the bases empty and two away. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Heading out towards shallow right. Markakis has a read on it. And that ends the inning. But two-run score for the Twins, both coming on this two-run home run. Middle of the night here at SunTrust Park. It's the Braves 10. Digging in once again, Ender Inciarte. He'll start things out in the home half of inning number five. Now the Twins are going to get a lefty up and throwing in the bullpen. Cut fastball in there for a called strike.
Well, Matt, look, it's real simple. If you're going to throw the ball down the middle in the big leagues, you're going to get hammered. He's got to put the ball in the corner if he wants to have any chance.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Fouled back. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Kepler going back on it, but he can't get it as it's off the wall. And he is into second base with a leadoff double.
As we take a look at this one, you can see he puts a good swing on it, but I don't think he got under just enough to put some backspin to get it out of here. But hard to complain about a well-hit double, though.
Into the box now, Dansby Swanson, as he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Here comes the 1-0. This is hit softly to third, and this will be gobbled up fairly easily down there at third for the first out.
The first baseman, number five, Freddie
Freeman. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Freddie Freeman. He flew out in his last at-bat.
first offering on its way.
D-Rod.
A fastball, and he swings through it to fall behind.
Now that's a big swing. That's what the big fella's supposed to do. Look to go downtown. Let it all fly. He let the dog out.
Meanwhile now, this is a fly out to straightaway right field, and it's going to get out of here. A home run. A two-run blast off the bat of Freddie Freeman. His second of the game as they push this lead up to 9 now. Excited to check the home run numbers that come out on ShowTrack, because that was just one of the most impressive launches we've seen in a good while. And as the numbers come in, that ball was projected to have carried over 460 feet. An amazing show of strength.
Now batting.
Standing in now, Matt Kemp. Started to go around there. Appeal down to first. Yes, sir, says the first base umpire. Strike one. The windup and the 0-1. A swing and a miss at the good old Uncle Charlie.
Well, there's no doubt what he was thinking on those first two swings. Big power swings. Now he's got to dial it back a little bit and try to put that ball in play.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And this is going to wind up a foul ball.
I like that. Show him the curveball and then try to sneak that low 90s fastball by him. It's going to look faster coming off those breaking pitches.
0-2 pitch is a curveball that misses 1-2. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats in left. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And the throw to first is there to record the second out.
The right fielder, number 22.
Ready once again, Nick Markakis. He's looking for hit number 3 here in this at-bat. Into the windup and the pitch. A little late on this one as it's lifted the other way down the left field line. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. A couple of runs on 2 hits, no errors, and no one left aboard.
Leading off for Minnesota, first baseman.
Digging in to try it again, Joe Mauer. He'll start things out now in the top half of the sixth. Starts him out with a curveball for a strike. Nothing in one count, here it comes. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Now batting. Third baseman.
Digging in once again, Miguel Sano. Been a strikeout victim twice in this one. Pulls the string on that one. One strike. Comes set with the 0-1. And he misses with it. 1-1. And he lays off for a ball. 2-1.
We've seen him go down on strikes more than once in this game, so this has been a better approach by him at this at bat. Much more patient. And he's gotten himself into a good hitter's count. Well, this has been a good job to work the count from 0-1 to 3-1. And now he's really in the driver's seat to see a heater that he can do something with.
Now batting, right fielder.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Max Kepler. He struck out twice thus far, so we'll see if he can fare any better here. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. And no one will get this one. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Twins are set down 1-2-3. They're down a bunch. It's 12-3. Ready once again, Brandon Phillips. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point.
Second baseman, Brandon Phillips.
Hit on the ground out to short. Throw on to first in time, one away.
Adonis Garcia digs in now. Two hits and three at-bats for him in this one. Line toward the alley in left center. Rosario is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two.
Up next for Atlanta, catcher Tyler Flowers.
Here now is the catcher, Tyler Flowers. He's 2-for-3 thus far. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And he commits to the pitch inside, and he definitely went around. That's strike one. And he lays off for ball one. Two out, nobody on. A swing and a miss at the big curveball. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. They're set down 1-2-3. They lead it big, though. It's 12-3. Striding in once again, Eddie Rosario. He'll lead it off here as we begin inning number seven. And he'll step on first himself for the out. Ready for another shot now, Byron Buxton. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score. Swing and a miss at a first pitch changeup, nothing in one.
Well, he swung right through that on that changeup. The changeup is a tough pitch to swing at for the first pitch because you haven't measured his velocity.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Definitely had the distance, but it winds up a foul ball. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big Jason strikeout, keep Castro. That guy off the base path.
Jason Castro is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one.
The difference maker in this outing than others is the two-seamer. He's doing whatever he wants to do with that ball. It's moving all over the place.
Couldn't wait back. A swing and a miss. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. Down go the Twins in order. They're down a bunch. It's 12-3. Now in the box, Ian Kroll. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. Some movement now in the Minnesota bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
Frozen with a high fastball there. We'll see if they try to climb the ladder even more on the next pitch.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Swing and a miss way behind the big fastball.
That ball's way out of the zone. He's got to set the sights lower. You're looking fastball, I like that, but make him get the ball down. They'll never catch up to it up there.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that, but most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss, and another strikeout.
Hit hard on the ground to short. In time to first, and there are two away.
Now batting, shortstop, Dansby.
And next will be Dansby Swanson digging in. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here. Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one.
He's done a nice job of getting those two quick outs before the two hitters come to the plate right now because he knows what's sitting down there down the order. So you stay aggressive against those little guys, try to get them out the way.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2. Swing and a miss at a big breaking ball, and that's how the inning comes to an end. Down in order go the Braves. They lead it big, though. It's 12-3. Kenny Vargas is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the eighth.
Kenny Vargas.
Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Flowers
waits on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
The batter, number two, second baseman,
Brian Dozier, will stand in again as he looks for home run number three in the ball game. As we flash you back here to his second home run. This was back in the fifth inning as he has the long ball working in his first few at-bats. First pitch on its way. That was a curveball that never really broke, stayed high.
He still might be looking for that release point on that curveball early in this outing. That one looked like it popped out of his hand behind his ear instead of out front. We'll see if he finds that pitch because it'll be important for him.
Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0. The 3-0 pitch. And this one will be fouled back in among the fans. Can't keep that one fair either, and now the count is full. He's set. Here's the 3-2. And this is swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number eight.
Now batting, shortstop.
Digging in the switch hitter, Jorge Polanco. They're quickly down to their final four outs here tonight. Here's the first pitch to him. Leaves a changeup high for a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. Bouncer down the line. That's a foul ball. Frozen on the fastball. Never had a chance, and the inning is over. Twins are set down 1-2-3. They're down a bunch. It's 12-3. Buddy Beshears enters now in a mop-up role, as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is.
Buddy.
Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. He'll have a new pitcher waiting for him as we begin their half of the eighth. And here's a ball hit in the air. And that's going to land foul. 0-1 count and the pitch. A swing and a miss on a ball that jammed him. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. So here's Matt Kemp now. And he's got a shot at history here, but he'll need a triple to complete the cycle. Now the pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a liner. But this is foul near the seats. A swing and a miss for out number two, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with. Here's Nick Markakis now, the right fielder. A couple of singles for him and four trips for him this afternoon. Lifted in the air to center. Buxton is there. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Braves are set down 1-2-3. So here's Joe Mauer starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point.
There's a swing and a high, deep drive headed for the right field corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. And this is chopped foul at the plate, and he stays alive, still 0-2. And he lays off the curveball. Strike three called, and that's going to be out number one.
Now batting, third baseman, Miguel Sano.
Here's Miguel Sano. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm a bit surprised to see the bullpen inactive right now.
Yeah, I'm with you, Matt. Even though he's pitching okay, I do think you have to look at what he's given you and realize he's probably approaching the end of his rope pretty soon. Last thing you want is for things to start to unravel and not have a guy ready that you can turn to. This lineup is flailing right now. They're having a hard time just making contact, let alone putting the ball in play.
Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
He's really racked up the strikeouts in this one, and this guy's been victimized three times already today. He and this lineup are clearly having a really tough time picking him up.
Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Grounded down the third baseline. Throw on to first, and the ball game is over.
Well, the tone was set for this game from the very first inning. They came out absolutely banging the ball around and took that great start to another notch in the win column.
12-3 is the way this one ends. The Braves with a big 17-hit attack. Phil Hughes allowed 7 earned runs to cross the plate in the losing effort. So that's a wrap for this afternoon. For Harold, Dan, and the rest of our crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network.
Of the ball game.